In this problem, we're asked to determine the value of the four pattern blocks in this first row, given the definition of the unit shown in the first column. So for this first row, one yellow pattern block equals one unit. We need to determine the value of each of these four pattern blocks. To work on this activity, we'll be using the pattern blocks using the National Library of Virtual Manipulatives. And here's a URL to the tool. So to begin, this is our unit, and therefore one yellow pattern block is equal to one. To determine the value of the red pattern block, we'll see how many red pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. Notice how it takes two red pattern blocks to make one unit, and therefore one red pattern block equals 1/2. And now we'll determine how many blue pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. It takes 1, 2, 3 blue pattern blocks to make one unit, and therefore each blue pattern block equals 1/3. And now determine how many green pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Because it takes 6 green pattern blocks to make one whole unit, we know each green pattern block equals 1/6. So we have 1, 1/2, 1/3, and 1/6. I also want to show a different approach to this type of problem, working from right to left. If we start with the smallest pattern block, which we know is equal to 1/6, we can use this to determine the value of the remaining pattern blocks using an equivalent fraction. For example, if we know one green is equal to 1/6, to determine the value of, let's say, a blue pattern block, because it takes 1, 2 green pattern blocks to make one blue pattern block, we know one blue pattern block is equal to 2/6. To determine the value of one red pattern block, we can determine how many green pattern blocks it takes to make this pattern block. Notice how it takes 1, 2, 3 green pattern blocks to make one red pattern block. Therefore, one red pattern block equals 3/6. And we can also express the yellow pattern block, which we can see here, as 6/6. So it'd also be correct to say one blue equals 2/6, one red equals 3/6, and one yellow equals 6/6. We could also say that one yellow is equal to 2/2, as well as 3/3. So we just need to be aware there can be more than one way to express the value of the pattern blocks. For the next row, three yellows make up the unit. So three yellows make up one unit. Notice how one yellow is equal to 1/3. Next we have the red pattern block. We'll begin by determining how many red pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. It takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 red pattern blocks to make one unit. One red pattern block equals 1/6. Next, we'll determine how many blue pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Because it takes 9 blue pattern blocks to make one unit, each blue is equal to 1/9. And now determine how many green pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. And I'm going to go ahead and speed this up. It takes 18 greens to make one unit, and therefore one green equals 1/18. And I do want to mention, if we did start with the smaller green piece, which is equal to 1/18, we could express these fractions with the denominator of 18. Let's look at one more example. Here the unit is defined as one red and one blue. So here's the unit. For this example, let's begin with the smallest pattern blocks, the green pattern blocks. We'll begin by determining how many green pattern blocks it takes to make one unit. It takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 green pattern blocks to make one unit, and therefore one green pattern block equals 1/5. Now we'll determine the value of the remaining pattern blocks using the green pattern block. Notice one blue pattern block is equal to 2 green pattern blocks. Each green pattern block is equal to 1/5, and therefore 1 blue is equal to 2/5. And now for the red pattern block, notice one red pattern block is equal to 1, 2, 3 green pattern blocks. Because each green pattern block is equal to 1/5, each red pattern block is equal to 3/5. And then finally we have the yellow pattern block. So now we'll determine how many green pattern blocks it takes to make one yellow pattern block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So because it takes 6 green pattern blocks to make one yellow pattern block, and each green pattern block is equal to 1/5, we have 6 copies of 1/5, or 6/5. So each yellow pattern block equals 6/5. Going back one last time, notice how because this amount in green is 5/5, or 1, we could also say one yellow pattern block is equal to 1 and 1/5. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.